Okay, so we were doing cross multiplication. You all have understood the cross multiplication method. We have completed first three questions, I think. Three questions we have completed.
First four
as well we have completed. Okay, start doing with fifth. Start fifth. Okay, today we'll be completing this exercise. Okay, few questions will be homework and we'll be completing them. Okay. Start with fifth question. So first, we'll be writing the equation. The equation is not in the form of ax plus by plus c equal to 0. Then we convert it in this form, okay? Both the equation will be writing in this form, okay? So everyone keep doing your work. So fifth question. X minus y minus 2 plus 2 equal to 0. This was the first equation. Second equation will be 130. We'll take it on left hand side. From right hand side, we'll take it on left hand side. 7x plus 9y minus 130 equal to 0. Okay. So next, what we have to write? We have to forget about the x quotient and we'll start with y quotient. So minus 1, 9, 2, minus 130. And then we again start with x and y. 1, 7, minus 1, and 9. Okay. This is for y, c, x, y. Okay, now cross multiply them. So this cross multiplication is for the denominator of x. This is the denominator for y. And this cross multiplication is denominator for constant term. Okay, I will solve them. How do we solve them? So minus 1 into minus 130, 130 minus 18 equal to y upon 14 minus 130 into 1 and minus minus it will become plus 130 equal to 1 upon 9 minus minus 7 plus 7. Are you getting this, everyone? Okay.
Yes.
Solve
sir.
Them further. Okay. Solve them further. You'll get the answer. So x upon 112 equal to y upon 144. 1 upon 16. Okay. Everyone solve. Are you getting the same, everyone? Okay. Keep solving. Keep solving. If you are not getting checked, somewhere you have made mistake. And always take care of the negative signs. Okay? Everyone solve it. So Abdul, what you have got the value for x? Abdul Azim Khan, what you have got the value for x? Today, Dakshan joined. Okay, so whenever you see a Dakshan lobby, please remind every teacher to admit him. I haven't got the password yet. I've been waiting for admin. I haven't got the password yet. And those students, okay, once I have told you to submit in one Google form, a Google form I uploaded in the group and you must submit the password there. So if you forget, you can ask me anytime. So those students who haven't submitted there, if they forget the password, I have to get it from the admin, okay? And admin rarely replies. I haven't got the reply yet. So I'll upload the Google form again. Those students who haven't submitted the password, please submit it there, okay? Fill that Google form, those who aren't filled. So around 30 students have filled till now from the class. Still few are remaining, okay? Everyone have got the answer? Just keep solving the questions. Okay, x equal to?
7.
We'll take first and last. 112 divided by 16. It is 7. Similarly for y, y upon 144. 1 upon 16. Y equal to 144 upon 16. 6. How much it is? 9.
9.
Okay, at last you write x equal to 7 and y equal to 9. Okay. Okay, everyone have got the answer? Yes.
If you put the value of x for second equation, then also correct.
Second equation. Okay, if you are solving first y.
No, sir, I am solving first. I get the value of the x and then I put the value of x in the first equation, x, that is x minus
okay.
y.
Okay. 7 you are putting, then you are solving for y. You can solve that way, but
question. Okay. In the question equation.
Okay, yes, you can put. You will get the answer. Okay. You can put anywhere. Here as well, you can put. You can put here as well. You will get the answer. Okay. Because, see here, what we are finding? We are finding the solution of x and y. So these values, they are going to satisfy these equations. They are solution of these equations. They are zeros of this equation. Okay. If you put those 7 and 9 here, see here, x is how much? 7. 7 minus 9, how much it is? Minus 2, plus 2, 0. So these solutions, they are also called zeros of this equation. That is solution of this equation. They are called as zeros of this equation. That is when we put these values in this equation, the equation gets satisfied. That means we are getting 0 as well on this side. Okay. Put here as well, it is satisfied. So these are solutions, so you can get it from anywhere. This both satisfies the values. So if you got the value of x, you can put it here, you can get the value of y from here, or from this equation. Okay? Because they are solution of those equations. Okay? Okay, sixth question. Everyone do sixth question. Okay, 7th, 8th, 9th will be homework. We start with 10th, okay? Do the sixth question. 7th, 8th, 9th will be homework. Okay, do the sixth question. So you have to take 5 from right hand side to left hand side. Okay, the equation must be in the form of ax plus by plus c. Okay. Okay, we are doing 7th question as well. Okay. We are doing 7th question as well. Okay. 8th and 9th and 10th will be homework. Okay. Everyone keep doing. So sixth question, we have to take 5, okay? 4x minus y minus 5 equal to 0 minus 4x plus 5y minus 7 equal to 0, okay? These will be the equations, okay? So we'll start with y quotients, minus 1, 5. Minus 5, minus 7. And again, so we are starting like this. 4, minus 4, minus 1, and 5. So y quotients. Y, C, X, Y. Okay, cross multiply. Okay. Everyone, keep doing your notebook without looking at the board. Just for checking, you can see on board. Keep doing your work in notebook. Okay. Copying won't help. Till you don't practice yourself, you won't be able to solve the questions. Okay. So keep solving the questions. Okay. So minus 1, minus 7, 7. 5 into 5, 25, minus, minus, plus. 20 minus minus plus 7 4 joule 28. Okay, keep solving.
So 20 plus 4.
Okay, see here. Okay, 1 upon 4 5 joule 20 minus minus 4 into minus 1 minus 4 into minus 1. So minus minus becomes plus 20 minus 4 you get. See here, three negatives are there. So one will remain. Is this clear?
Yes,
minus
sir.
4 into minus 1. Okay. Solve them. So solve the value for x, solve the value for y. Okay. Anyone who still haven't understood, this method, see, it's very easy method. Yes or no? After practicing 6 or 7 questions, don't you feel easy? It's easy method?
Yes, sir.
Okay, keep doing. Sixth question, as you complete, tell me, everyone.
All done.
Okay, what will be the value of x?
2.
X upon 32 equal to 1 upon 16. That is, x equal to 32 upon 16, x equal to 2. And y upon 48 equal to 1 upon 16. Y equal to 48 upon 16. How much it is? 3.
3.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Everyone who got the same answer? Okay. Now look at the seventh question. First, you have to write in this form of ax plus by plus c. Okay. So is there any c term there?
So we can
put
zero as c term.
We can put c as zero. Yes, zero as c. Okay. So how you are going to write? First equation 4x plus. It is minus, minus 3y. Now, since no equal to 0 is given, we need c term plus 0 equal to 0. Okay. Adding 0 won't change anything. Yes or no? Okay. So, first equation will be like
minus 0.
Minus 0 you want to put. Does it matter? Minus will create more trouble for us. Yes or no?
Yes.
It's better. Plus 0 minus 0 doesn't mean. You can put minus 0, no issues. It won't mean anything. Multiply anything with minus 0 or plus 0, you will get the 0 as answer. Okay? And usually 0, minus 0, plus 0, all are 0 only. There is no quantity that can be positive or negative since there is no quantity. Okay? Second equation, 2x plus 3y minus 18. Equal to 0. Okay. Now everyone solve it. 4, 2, minus 3, 3, 0, minus 18, and okay, 1 minute. 1 minute, I made a mistake. 1 minute. 1 minute. Minus 3, 3, 0, minus 18, 4, 2, minus 3, 3. Okay. Here, 0 have made something easy. So, x upon first cross multiplication. First cross for x, second cross for y, and third cross for the constant term. So, minus 3 into minus 18, it will be plus
54.
54 minus 0. Y upon, this is 0 minus
0.
See here, 0 minus minus 18 into minus minus 18 into 4 minus 72. Okay, equal to 1 upon 4 3 is a 12, then minus minus 6. So it will become plus 6. Understood? So x upon 54 equal to y upon 72 equal to 1 upon 18. They all are multiples of 18, you can see. 18 4 ja. So y equal to 4 you get. And 18 3 ja. X equal to 3 you get. So keep solving the question. Next three questions are for homework. 8, 9, 10. Do 11th question. Okay, do 10th question. Do 10th question, we are having time. 50 minutes are there. So these three questions will solve. Okay, keep solving. I think we'll complete the whole exercise in class. Okay, keep solving 10th question. 10th, 11th, 12th we'll do first, then we'll start with 8th and 9th, okay? So, do 10th question. Abdul, are you able to solve? Abdul, Abrar, Aditya. Have you understood? Okay, everyone do 10th question. 10th question, do it, 10th question. Solve 10th question. And tomorrow we'll start the next exercise, okay? Solve 10th question. See here, these three exercises are very important to understand so that we will be able to solve the 6D and 6E exercise. Okay, 6A will be word problems. So these exercises are must to understand them. Okay. Okay, so 10th question. Again, convert the equation in the standard form. 4x plus 6y minus 15 equal to 0. Second equation, 3x minus 4y minus 7 equal to 0. Okay. Now, cross multiplication will start with y, c, x, y. Six minus four. It's better we can start y, c, y here. So it, we can easily put minus 15, minus 7, 4, 3, 6, minus 4. And take the cross multiplication. Okay. So x upon 6 sevens are 42. It will be minus 42. Minus, 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 it will become plus here. 15 fours are 60. Equal to y upon 15 threes are minus 15 into 3. Minus 45. And minus sign. And minus 7 into 4, minus 28. Minus, it will become plus 28. Equal to 1 upon 4, 4 just 16. It is minus 16. Minus 18. Okay. Keep solving. Everyone keep solving. So it will be how much x upon 102 and negative signs. Y upon 17.
17 minus 17.
Minus 17. Okay. And how much it will be? 34.
Minus 34.
Minus 34. Okay. So see here, we can, all the three are having negative sign, we can remove here or we can remove it later. Okay. So x will be how much?
3.
102 divided by 34. So it is 3. And y equal to 17 upon 34. Minus minus get cancelled. How much it is?
1/2.
1/2. Okay. If you're solving in a line, there must be gap. Or else 3y you may determine. You may write. This is clear to everyone. Everyone have understood or not? These three exercises are very must to understand the next two exercises. Okay. 6D and 6A. If you are not able to solve these three exercises, you won't be able to solve the next two, or you won't be able to understand the next two. So solve each and every question. Okay. 11th question. Okay, give me a hint what we can do with these numbers, since decimal numbers are there. And only one decimal place is there. One decimal. A digit after decimal is only one.
So we can remove.
We can remove the decimals. Okay, so we can write 4x minus 15y minus 65 equal to 0. Okay, similarly with the second, we can remove. Okay,